Okay, I've already started getting some of it shredded. And I've got it here in my dish pan. I'm just doing it with a knife. You can do it with your electric shredder or whatever. I'm just doing it the old-fashioned way, a sharp knife, and I have quartered it and took the core out, and I'm just going to continue. Now, I weighed mine, and I've got 6 pounds, so this should do a half-gallon jar of fermented healthy sauerkraut. So what I do is just put it in here and separate it. So I will finish getting this other head shredded, and then I'll bring y'all back and we'll put the salt on it. And then you let it set with the salt for a designated time. And then we'll massage the far out of it and get it in the jar and start the 2 to 3 week process of making some homemade, very high probiotic, healthy sauerkraut. Be back in a little bit. You want to save one of your big outside leaves that you can put on the top and weight down to keep everything below the level of the shredded sauerkraut. And I've taken out part of the core so I could wash it. And I'm just going to quarter this and shred it up. Just was going to let y'all kind of see what I'm doing here. I've got it halved and I'm just going to try to cut at an angle and get the core out so I don't have to deal with it. Okay, now I'm just going to cut this on in half again. And I'll do the same to this other half and then I'll shred it. Okay, y'all, I've shredded my 6 pounds of cabbage. Some of it's bigger than the other because I just used a knife. And I've put 3 tablespoons of salt in here because I'm putting 2 teaspoons per pound. 6 pounds, that's 12 teaspoons or 4 tablespoons. So then you put your salt in and you just kind of toss it around so that some of the salt is on all of it. And because I just did that, I can already see the water being pulled out. So you let it rest like this for about 20 minutes. And then I'm going to come in with my hands and just massage it and squeeze it. And then I'll pack it in the jars, and the juice that's worked out of it is the brine that I pour over it to ferment it. Now, just in case you don't have enough brine to cover the cabbage, you can make a brine with 1 teaspoon of salt per cup of water. You don't want chlorine in your water, so if you're where there's chlorine, you're going to want to buy you some spring water. I'm going to let this set for 20 minutes, and I'll bring y'all back and show you how I'm squeezing it and rubbing it, and they call it massaging it, and breaking it down. And I'm anxious to get it in. I think I'm going to put it in a half gallon jar and see how I do. The big pieces, like when you see something that looks like part of the core, you might want to take that out.
It's actually been about 30 minutes
and you can see that this is damp, and I don't know if you can see or not, there is liquid in the bottom. So what I'm going to do now is start squeezing it, and I'm going to do this. I know my hands are going to give out, but I'm going to do it for about 5 minutes, and the salt and the pressure from my hands will start to break the cabbage down, and it will release more liquid. I should have about enough to cover it in the jar, but if I don't, I'll make my solution and add some to it and have enough to keep it covered while it ferments. I have fermented pickles. I've showed y'all that in a video. I've done carrots. I've done jalapeno peppers. I have just never done cabbage. I try to keep something fermented in the refrigerator because it has so much healing power. So make you some fermented food. There's a lot of instructable, or whatever you want to call it, videos. There's lots of instructions out there on YouTube that you can follow. See how this is breaking down? I actually refreshed myself on this by watching 2 or 3 different videos.
It's
very good to listen to more than one because everybody has a little bit different take and a little bit something that'll help you. Now, I'm going to keep doing this. I'm going to turn the camera off where y'all won't have to listen to me rattle the whole time. But I will be back and show y'all when I start jarring it up. Okay, I've massaged and massaged and massaged it, and I've got a clean. I'm going to put it in a gallon jar. I'm not sure what it would fit in. So I'm going to put it into this gallon jar. It might would fit in a half gallon. I don't know. And I'm just going to keep sticking it in here and pressing it down. And then we'll put the brine. I'm not going to have enough brine, I can tell you. I'm going to have to make some more. But let me finish this and get it in here, and then I'll bring y'all back and show you how much I have my brine in. And we'll see how far up the jar it comes, and I'll have to, I'm sure, make some more. Yeah, I don't know about have enough. I'm probably going to have to make 2 cups. Okay, I'm going to do to a cup of water, I'm going to put a teaspoon of fine granulated sea salt and dissolve that, and I'll add it in, and I'll be right back.
Okay, I've got 2 cups of water, and I'm going to get my measuring spoons and put 2 teaspoons of salt in.
And I may not need it all, that's okay. I won't be wasting a whole lot if I waste a little bit of it. Okay, let me stir that to dissolve it. And that's filtered water. I put it in my Berkey, and then I put it through a Brita filter to be sure that there's nothing left in it that shouldn't be there. Okay, we're going to add it until my cabbage is covered. Look at that. We didn't have to put much. It's pretty well done. I'm going to add a little bit more. It's okay to have a little bit of extra
juice.
I'll just go ahead and add it all, because some of it may evaporate during the process. I don't know. Okay, I'm going to clean my jar up. And I'm going to get me a cabbage leaf and put on the top of the cabbage here to try. Well, I'm not really having trouble with it floating up right now. I'll bring y'all back in just a minute and show you
okay,
what
I've done.
Okay, I'm going to have to piece my 2 cabbage leaves together. So I'm going to put one over to this edge. I had to cut a bad spot off, and it's won't reach across now. Put that one over there, and then I'm going to put a weight on the top to try to hold that down, and I'll put my lid on it, and I'm going to set it on the counter where it doesn't get a whole lot of light, and it'll take, they say, a couple of weeks. You just have to keep tasting it till it gets the sauerkraut taste that you want. Now I'm all about not washing any more dishes than I have to. So this is the leaves that I put on the top to keep my cabbage down. And then these are the little weights that I told you. These are for a regular mouth ball jar. But I just put 3 of them in there to hold this down to where the cabbage would stay under the brine. But keep a year in the refrigerator. Got me a fork, and I'm just going to get me a bite out of the jar, and let's see what it tastes like. Of course, I've already tasted it. I'm just going to let y'all see. It's crunchy,
and it's
good.
But
I hope y'all have enjoyed watching the process, and I hope it inspire you to make some fermented food. If you have any questions about fermentation, there's a wonderful website that I have gleaned knowledge from for a year or two now, and it's Cultured Food Life. And Cultured Foods healed her and her daughter. So if you want to know more about it, because I haven't studied enough to teach you or to give you the facts or all of that, I just know it's good for me. I'm convinced, and so we eat it. But you can go to culturedfoodlife.com and read what she has documented and read her story. That's where I started learning to make my sourdough bread in the beginning, was because she made it. And I've done
I've done fermented carrots, now cabbage, I've done jalapeno peppers. I've done some of her mixed recipes that she has on there. Every bit of
it's
good. Go to her channel. Listen to some stuff that she does. Tell them that Gay Jordan sent you if you happen to place an order. Because I told them that. And tell them at Apron Strings. Because I told them that I might be using them in some of my videos. So I'd like for y'all to document that. But anyway, hope y'all have a blessed day. I hope you're thinking about eating healthy and adding some healthy things to your menu and to your what you make. The good Lord bless y'all and come back here in a day or two and we'll do something else.